and we are giving our 100% to make this comeback for the motorsports in India, and we are trying our best to make it a big success, and also we are trying to lay the path for the youngsters in India for the motorsports, which always has been like a dream to get into the motorsports, especially in India for the Indian drivers. But my trial over here is to make that happen, create a path for the Indian drivers, and give them better training and give them more opportunity to get it done.
Let me ask Neil, you are our guest, but you have an Indian connection, right? So how it feels like to be in India, and what would be your message to youngsters who are trying to get into motorsports?
Well, first of all, thanks for having me here. It's been some time since I've been last to India. It was 2015. We did the Golden Triangle Tourist Tour at the time. To the south of India. Normally a bit more direction, and it was the most out I ever went. I think we have a little bit of a misconnection on the... Obviously Gujarati, my mom is Swiss, so that's my Indian connection, and it's always nice to be back. And you know, first Indian Racing League, when I got asked by Aditya and the guys if I'm interested to join and come have a look, I said sure, November is a good month. Very curious to, you know, see how that gets started and if I can help to make it grow and help the motorsports in India. I'm sure here I'd like to support it.
I've always been interested in cars, racing as a kid, and obviously eventually I'd want to try something within the sport. So I hopped into a car about like 4 or 5 years ago, and I was pretty quick in the cars, and then just came out of it, and then just explored what else we have in India, and then now I'm going to be racing. And obviously the racing league thing, first time running this year, obviously a great honor to be part of it with the team boys. So just looking forward to the preseason with us and then head about next week.
Right, thank you. Bianca, you are here. I was reading about you. You started at the age of 5 in pro-karting, and you are one of the most competitive drivers today. How do you look at Asian motorsports now, and what's your plans and what do you think about India?
So thank you guys so much for coming here. It's an honor, really, you know, coming from Philippines where motorsport is not very well developed and there's not much opportunities. I think that's one of the main things that lacks a lot in Asia, you know, representative and just overall the community. So it really is amazing that to have, you know, the Indian Racing League, you know, giving opportunities not just to Indian drivers, but actually inviting international drivers like me and Neil, as well as women drivers. You know, we've got about 5 women drivers in the grid in the next few weeks, and you know, to have that opportunity to be given that exposure as well, to be driving in all these tracks, and I think that just really equalizes everything. You know, we will be driving the same cars as everyone else, very equal. And so, you know, for that initiative for Indian Racing League to start, you know, it really says a lot, and I know that there's a lot more we're going to work at, and you know, it's only the first year, and I'm really, really super excited. You know, as someone that's been driving since the age 5, I've had to deal with a lot of struggles and a lot of lack of opportunities, especially coming from Philippines. And so, you know, this year is my first ever rookie season in Formula Cars. I came out straight from karting, and as you know, relevantly because of the pandemic, I wasn't able to drive for 2 years. So basically 2 years of no racing for me and pretty much everyone in Asia. So to see the series starting again and the motorsport community blooming and ongoing is just really amazing. And you know, I'm really excited to be driving with all these drivers. It's my first time in India, so I'm really excited. I mean, the past few days has been a journey. And looking at into the culture and all the tracks and all the people, it really is amazing. I honestly can't wait.
Look forward. All the best to you. Rohan, last question is to you. You are the one who was picked up by Ferrari Driver Academy. How's been your experience of motor racing locally, and what difference you see in India when you drive in India?
Yeah, it's a really nice thing to be here. I'm really happy, really excited. It's really interesting, very competitive, obviously. It's developing motorsports in India a lot, and India is catching up. And at the level of European motorsports, if you look at it from this championship, we've got international drivers like Neil here, and we've got a lot of young Indian talents as well, who learn a lot and hopefully perform well as well.
Thank you everyone. I think
at the end of the year, lots of things don't happen at the end of the year for racing, and it's just great to actually make it happen and make opportunities for us international drivers as well. Since I can't find much racing there, so this is great coming to another country, seeing another kind of religion and seeing different people and meeting different people. It's great. Thank you.
Thank you. Vishnu, can we have a few words from you? How are you looking at this league and what's your experience like being?
Yeah, it's a great opportunity for us Indian drivers. I think it's a platform that's been needed for a long time, and it's a great platform for us to showcase our talent and also learn from a lot of these international drivers here. So yeah, it's going to be a very good and interesting couple of weeks for us, and hopefully we're going to learn a lot.
John, congratulations for winning the World Cup yesterday. How does it feel to be on track? What is pulsating about? What draws you towards the track, and how you're looking at it in racing league?
It's great. You know, it's not my first time. I've been here 10 years ago, racing here. So it's nice to be back. It's always a country I've had good relationship with. And it's just nice to see that a real sort of racing opportunity now over here. You know, it's a proper market for motorsport. You've got some real, real enthusiastic fans in motorsport. Every time I've been here, the enthusiasm and the positivity around the place is just insane. So just to have, you know, a real professional league that is hopefully going to, you know, just go and take off now and pick up a real force in world motorsport, it's going to be great. You know, to be part of that from day one is always exciting. You know, to try and have something grow and just shed some experience. It's just a privilege to be a part of, and I see it's going to be an exciting four race weekends. I'm sure there's plenty of action about to hear for everybody. So yeah, happy to be a part of the Chennai Turbo Riders, and let's go try and bring some home trophies.
So John is from UK, that's why I congratulated him. Parth, you are the one who probably was in the Ferrari Drivers Academy and probably the first Indian. So how's your experience been globally, and what is so special about India in driving your own country?
Yeah, well, hopefully it's going well. It's a big opportunity, like everybody said, come something so big here, and we're just going on about it. But this is really big for all of us, especially Indian guys here, because we don't have as much opportunities as what we have in Europe. But this is something like which is going to give us a big break here. But it's good to have John and Vishnu, who I know very well, and me and Vishnu go together to be on the same team. So I hope we go ahead with it and get some podium, like John said.
Thank you. I think Chennai team should.
Current world champion, right? Oracle Red Bull Racing. So we are there in motorsports. Coming, why in India? We have seen, you know, it might be a nascent industry or it might be a nascent sport, but we see that, you know, there is a lot of potential. We see the audience. In fact, the audience who there definitely is a potential for us as a company to be associated with motorsports. And for that, you know, we'd like to wish the Indian Racing League all the very best. Thank you so much.
First and passionate about motorsport, but I don't really have the opportunities to do that, because even I have been in that position when I was a kid, because I'm really passionate about motorsports, but there was no proper infrastructure or path to it. So my only vision is to create that and give a path to the youngsters to get into motorsports.
Thank you.
A couple of corners which is going to change for Formula E, because according to the aspect, we need the energy regeneration in the cars. So we want to be a little, I think, 3 to 4 more corners, and this is going to be a fast track, but that's going to be a little lesser speed. The infrastructure available. So by this week, first couple of years, we will be showcasing what exactly is the motorsports, and then people will start getting interested. So automatically, when people get start interested and when they go to the go-kart tracks and all, so slowly when the business comes up, the tracks will come up. So that's how the infrastructure development will be done. And then we are planning for a couple of other things as well. As they are still in the pipeline, we have not confirmed anything, but we are still planning for a couple of other things where we can put a route to the Indian drivers to the international stage. So that will give another exposure for the Indians, and hopefully it will get the same passion and enthusiasm as the people have on the cricket. The only reason I feel is that the opportunity and the path is not there for the motorsport. So people are more interested in the cricket because they have the path. If you do well, if you play well, you can go to any extent in the cricket. So I want to do the same thing.